Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to East Long Meadow Rec Basketball March Madness Final Four here. What an exciting evening this will be as we have both Final Four matchups. The first game is between the light blue team and the black team. And the second game is between the red team and I believe it is the green team. Is that right?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. And anyways, the black team are coming off a win against the white team, which I believe is an upset because they beat the white team 54-46, and the white team really only had one loss throughout the season. Technically, they had four losses, but a forfeit count as three losses in rec basketball, so that's an interesting thing, but they only had one actual loss during the season, and they were upset by the black team in their previous matchup, and earlier the black team did not get a bye, so they did have to play in the first round, and they beat the orange team. And this light blue team is the number one seed coming into this game. They just beat the gray team, which my team, the dark blue team, lost to by around 15 points in the first round. And the light blue team just beat the gray team 52-51. So that was a good game. We've had a series of good games. Have you had a chance to catch any playoff basketball so far?
Yeah, I did. I've seen some of them on YouTube for LCAT just to see what's been going on. Yep. And, of course, my dark green team played against the maroon team, who I believe also got eliminated. And we lost to them, but we made a really good run, and we just fell a little short. But tonight's matchup looks like it'll be a really close, hard-fought game.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Both teams have quite the good amount of athletes. So it's always interesting to watch these games. We are ready to tip this one. It's going to be Dan Lombardo and Andrew Walls who will do the tip for each of their teams.
I'd say they're probably two of the tallest players in the league.
Yeah, definitely one. Some of them. So those of you who don't know, there are two 20-minute halves, and the clock does not stop running until the final 2 minutes. And we're ready for some Final Four action here of rec basketball. Ball's up, and the black team gains the first possession of the ball game.
Look for the black team to just keep shooting from the outside. They've got plenty of those.
Yeah, they definitely have some good shooters, and also with the size of Dan Lombardo, he can shoot the ball pretty well too, and as well as drive the lane just like that. Nice move by Dan Lombardo, a little bit too much. Rebound by Walls, gives it up to Mooney. Here's Matt Mooney, quick jumper. That's off the mark. Blocked by Dan Lombardo. Here's Andy Smith in the corner for three. That's good. 19-20 to go in the first half. And just like that, the light blue team's on top 3-0.
Yeah, I saw in the warm-ups, Andy Smith was just burying shots left and right. So let's see if he'll transfer that to the game.
Yeah, I remember when my team played him, he had several three-pointers. He can shoot the ball pretty well. Nice block there, and he tried to save it, but he didn't have to because it was tipped in the backcourt. But Black gains possession anyways. Here's Joey Santinello, gives it up to Dan Lombardo. Down low, off the glass, too much rebound by Dan Lombardo, and he misses short. Rebound by Walls.
So far, both teams can't really convert on second chance opportunities.
Dan Lombardo for three. That's a little bit too much.
I'm sure that won't be the last time we'll see Lombardo take a three from out there, even with his remarkable size.
Here's Matt Mooney. If you want to talk about Matt Mooney, he is quite the athlete. I believe he will be playing soccer, Division I soccer at UMass next fall.
Yeah, that's impressive.
Very impressive. And he's quite the basketball player, too. He's very fast. He's very hard to defend, and this one's thrown away. Blue team on top 5-0 with 17:45 to go. Here's Andy Smith. Matt Mooney once again with the drive floater. That's too much. Blue team seems to be controlling the tempo early.
Yes. They've been getting more shots off and more quality shots as the black team just looking lost early.
Oh, knocked away by Nick Demarest in the backcourt, picked up by Santanello.
They gotta start, black team's gotta start making better passes or it's just gonna lead to quick points for the blue team.
And they've had a hard time finding good quality shots. That's a nice poke back there by Jake Wilson. And they get their first points of the night.
Black team really needed that after just a short run to start the game for blue.
Dan Lombardo behind the back, puts that one up and in. Nice move by Dan Lombardo.
Now that's what you want to see if you're Coach Douglas, just seeing arguably your best player, Dan Lombardo, get started early.
Andy Smith almost falls there. Manages to stay up on his feet, knocked away. Matt Moody picks it up, drives the lane, puts it off the glass, no good. And a foul is called against blue. You know, I don't think any in-town teams have team names.
No, they don't.
Yeah, I remember our team, we're just known as the blue team, or Team Skiffington, because he was our coach, but teams are just known by their coach's name or by the color of their jersey. No one comes up with names.
But that's usually when you think of the team color, there's always one player you think of for each team.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And speaking of which, here's Matt Mooney driving, and he's fouled.
Blue team looking to just go right at the Blacks defenders down low and just get shots and rebounds. It's like Mike Pepper checks into the game.
Mike Pepper is quite the shooter. And just like that, he puts up a three. They're going to call that one a three. It looked close, but
I really thought that was a two.
Yeah, I did too. The far side ref signaled a three, so now it's 8-4. Blue team on top. Look down low. I mean, that's a tough spot to pass to, especially in a zone defense.
Yeah.
And we got some substitutions here for the blue team.
Looks like Brian Coles checks in.
Dan Lombardo, nice look down low, and he's going to be fouled.
Smart pass there by Lombardo, seeing his teammate underneath and draws a foul.
Got some subs here for the black team. Chap in the game, Peterson, and Denzel.
Seems like all the golfers coming in.
Yeah. Noah Peterson is actually quite the golfer, I've heard, and Chap is a pretty good golfer too. Here's a big putback by Dan Lombardo.
Seemed like nobody boxed him out there, and he just went right in and grabbed that offensive rebound.
Yeah, and here's a steal by Chap. Cows falling to the floor, and Chap puts it off the glass and in. Brian Cowles fell hard to the floor.
Seems like momentum has just shifted in the past 10 seconds.
And just like that, we're tied up at 8-8. Here's Felix Trangisi checking into the game.
Boy, the fans are starting to get into this.
Yeah. There's quite the student section here tonight.
Yep.
In this Final Four matchup. That Moody in the corner, guarded by Chap. Cowles kicks it off to the wing, back up on top to him. Over to Matt Mooney. Drives over Dan Lombardo. No good. Rebound by Matt Paul. That's no good.
Those are the ones you just have to make for the blue team to keep with the strong tempo of the black team.
Some angers flaring on both sides.
That one appeared to be a frustration foul.
Yeah. Noah Peterson looking to drive, and it's just going to go back down the other way. Mike Pepper. Over on the wing. Back up on top. He's going to shoot another three. That's a little bit short. Rebound, Felix Trangizi.
Even though he missed there, if you're the black team, you probably don't want to leave him open like that again.
Dan Lombardo tried to fire a pass down the floor to Chappie. He almost came up with it, but it was a little bit too much. So we got 12:20 to go in the first half. The clock does not stop running until the final 2 minutes of the half. And what looked like a shot could have been a pass down to Matt Paul. And a jump ball, and it's going to go back down to the black team.
Yeah, Blues got to start capitalizing on their second chances. They're just not being able to put it back up and in.
Chat looking to drive, gives it up to Lombardo. Fadeaway off the glass is no good. Blue team looking to push the floor. Matt Moody looking to take it all the way. And man, did he fall pretty hard to the floor.
Good job, though, by drawing the contact, and maybe he'll give his team the lead here at the line.
Very aggressive game early on. Knocks down the first. Lombardo coming out for the first time tonight.
Sure that this game will be tight throughout, as it has been early on.
Joey Santinello gives it over to Chap. And it's almost taken away, and then they get tied up in a jump ball. It's going to go back down to Blue.
Blue starting to figure this flag team out defensively. They didn't have an answer for him earlier, but now they do.
And Mike Pepper gets a second three of the night. He's putting the Blue team on top, 13-8.
Just can't leave him open like that.
And it's a steal by Mike Pepper. He's going to take it all the way to the bucket, and he's fouled. Almost gets that one to go, and one.
Since Pepper's come in, his team's just come to life, it seems like. He's been the spark that this Blue team has needed.
Yeah, he's already had two quick threes. And now he has a chance to put two more on his point resume. Chat for three. That's too much. Cowles with the rebound.
Good job boxing out Trangizi there.
Matt Moody. Wow, what a move.
Just displaying his athleticism right there, changing directions while mid-flight.
Yeah, I was just going to say the same thing. So now Blue is now double the black team score at 16-8 with 10:13 to go. We're going to see what we can do tonight. We're going to see if we can get a couple interviews on here and have some fun. During this Final Four matchup, we can see if we can get some other Spartan athletes down here to talk during these games. But as of now, it is 16-8. Blue team on top of the black team here in a very aggressively fought game so far.
As it seemed like the very beginning of the first half, it just belonged to the black team, but Blue team just has started to come to life. And
yeah.
All of a sudden, they're up by eight.
Yeah, the Blue team is the number one seed in the bracket, and the black team is the number six team. It's almost stolen. It is stolen again by Mike Pepper. And he's fouled by Noah Peterson.
Peppers is performing really well right now as a two-way player, providing output offensively and defensively.
Mike Pepper, drive, and he gets two more. 18-8.
Man, is he on fire. Dan Lombardo checks back into the game.
This is Joey Santinello. Kicks in the corner and a lob up to Dan Lombardo. Can't come up with it. Here's Mike Pepper. He's going to get fouled. You know, a lot of people would be surprised when they hear, you know, rec basketball. They're like, oh, it's probably very low competitive. But clearly, as displayed here, it can be pretty highly competitive and pretty intense at times.
Yeah, I mean, just this past season was my first season. I really look forward to the next three as it's just a ton of fun, it seems like, just to watch and to play.
Yeah. I mean, people who don't take basketball too seriously and don't want to show off for the school team, this is a great option for those who, you know, are athletic or just want to have some fun. And everyone enjoys their time here in in-town basketball. Walls, it's the second one. It's 19-8 now. Black team needs to get in a rhythm now.
Yeah, they haven't scored in what seems like forever.
Gets into the post for two. No good. Here's Walls. Slowing it down over to Andy Smith. Mike Pepper once again for three. That's Walls short. Saved to Jake Wilson. And it's stolen again by Mike Pepper. Wow. Mike Pepper, that was his third steal so far tonight.
Yeah, he's just really shown up to play here in the first half. And if he keeps this up, blue team should be very tough to beat.
Yeah, almost got his fourth steal there. But he's called for a reach-in foul anyway, so we have 7:40 to go. In the first half here, here's Jake Wilson down the baseline. Joey Santinello for three. That's no good. And a rebound. And it's gained by the black team. Deep three. It's good. Joey Santinello looking to spark the black team offense right now. 19-11.
Yeah, first time they've scored it. And looks like we got a foul called here. But it's been the first time the black team has scored in, I would say, at least 5 minutes.
So it's already 1-1, 17 fouls on the black team. Mike Pepper will go to the line.
I would say half of these team fouls has just been fouling Mike Pepper to stop him from beating them down the floor.
Yeah. And the black team just comes up with that rebound, stolen again by Mike Pepper. Puts it up way too much. And I believe a jump ball is called.
At this rate, Pepper's just going to be in double figures and steals by the time the night's over.
Already has four steals. And this one's thrown into the middle of the paint. And picked up again by the blue team.
Yeah, Black's just not doing a good job taking care of the ball right now.
Kicks it back out. Andy Smith, pump fake. Kicks it over to Mike Pepper for another three. No good. Nick Demers with the rebound. Gives it over to Walls. Walls out to Andy Smith. He wants a three. That's way too much. Picked up by Mike Pepper again. Blue team just dominating right now. And a rainbow floater by Mike Pepper gets that one to go. It's 21-11.
Man, he just come out playing so well. He's just been burning the black team's defense.
Yeah. That was a rainbow floater by Mike Pepper.
Couldn't have done it any better.
I mean, this is what we mean by how these games can be very highly competitive, and there's some pretty talented basketball players, believe it or not, in this rec league.
Yeah, I mean, as you see, Dan Lombardo scores there.
Nice job by Dan Lombardo to get the basket.
Tons of players throughout the league that are just, like, some of the seniors are just impressive here. For the pink team, Tyler Miller. For the light green team, Nick Lambert. I mean, they just know how to play.
Then Lombardo almost finds Jake Wilson down low. It was a nice look, but it was tipped out of bounds by Jake Wilson. And we have a late arrival to the game here. It's Tanner Patterson just showing up for the black team. Maybe he's that missing piece that they're missing.
Right now, the black team just committing too many turnovers, and they just haven't seemed to find an answer for Mike Pepper and the blue team defensively.
Cowell's looking to drive, and it's picked up by Andy Smith and lay it in. I mean, if they don't score the first time, they're scoring either the second or the third time.
I mean, with Mike Pepper on the bench, maybe they'll have a chance to score some points, but the blue team all around is just playing well. I think that might be Noah Pearson's third foul. He seems like he's had quite a few already.
Yeah, it's 25-13 now as we are just 3 minutes and 40 seconds away from heading into halftime. The light blue team, pretty commanding 12-point lead right now. Matt Paul at the line looking to make it more.
Yep, they're just showing right now why they're the number one seed.
That's a good point. And Matt Paul banks in the free throw. Here's Dan Lombardo, looking to pull up, gives it to Denzel. Back over to Dan Lombardo, off the glass. No good, rebound by Chatelain. Throws it up, no good, rebound by Dan Lombardo. And he puts it in. The black team's gonna need a couple more of those. And Matt Moody right down the other way to lay it in.
Back to that last offensive possession for the black team. If you're the blue team, you have a lead now, but you don't want to keep letting Lombardo get offensive rebounds.
Yeah.
So that's what will hurt you.
I mean, if he doesn't get it the first time, he'll definitely score on his second. Here's Andy Smith. He'll take a three. That's too much. Rebound by Trangizi. And here's Lombardo. Lombardo looking to drive, picks it up, off the glass and in. 11-point game, blue team on top.
If Lombardo starts to get going, you better look out if you're the blue team.
And Matt Mooney is called for another foul. I believe that's his second foul. And right back down the other way. Andy Smith hits a big bucket for the blue team.
Yeah, careless inbound pass leads to the score on the other end.
And once again, fast break layup, off the glass, no good. And a foul, Matt Mooney. I believe that's his third personal foul. And he's probably going to have to come out of the game here.
From my eyes, that didn't really look like a foul, but either way, It's tough to have him in foul trouble.
Yeah, Matt Moody's going to come out, and Mike Peppers is going to come into the game. Now, minute 37 to go in the first half. Light blue team's on top, 30-17. Tanner Patterson is going to come in for the first time tonight. Looking to spark the black team offense.
Yeah, I believe that Dalen Barr might have been shaken up on that last play. That might be why he's come out.
And this one's stolen by Brian Cowles. He's going to drive it all the way, and he's fouled. He doesn't make the layup, though. And he's going to go to the line to shoot two, looking to make it a 15-point game.
Yeah, just another lazy pass there by the black team, and Coles takes advantage of it. Goes down the other end, draws a foul.
And she makes a second one, 31-17. Chap brings it up, gets it over to Noah Peterson. Almost stolen, and it is stolen. Here's Andy Smith back down the other way, lays it up and in.
Blue team is just fundamentally sound on defense. And, oh!
Wow, another steal. And a hard foul this time. And Andy Smith will go to the line to shoot two after he just made a fast break layup on the other side. I think the black team is having some pretty lazy passes early on, and that's what led to many steals that transitioned to points for the blue team.
Yeah, they're just not really focusing on where they're passing the ball. They're just throwing it to them and not realizing that there's blue coming in late.
Well, hopefully they can turn it around in the second half so this can become a little bit more interesting of a game.
Yeah, it started off close in about the first 5 minutes, and after that, it's just been all blue.
It is 33-17 with 46 seconds to go. Light blue team is winning. He hits the second one, 34-17. And it's stolen once again. Mike Pepper, lay it up and in.
Just incredible.
It's got to be his fifth or sixth steal.
Things just going bad to worse for Black on offense.
Mike Pepper, top of the key over to the wing. And nice rebound by Matt Paul, but Chap comes up with it. Chap looking to push the floor. And a nice block by Mike Pepper, no foul call. 6 seconds to go.
This is all-around game. Mike Peppers has just been spot on and really what the blue team needed going into this one.
They get it in, and he's fouled.
Now, if you're the black team going into the half, you're going to want to figure out how to stop Mike Pepper and how to just cut back on the turnovers.
Yes, because a lot of the turnovers by the black team has transitioned to many points offensively for the blue team. And that's why the blue team is up 36-17, basically because of all the turnovers so far from the black team. Tanner Patterson looking to knock down the second free throw. No good. Nice rebound by Dan Lombardo with 3 seconds to go. Off the glass. 1 second to go. And out of bounds. And that's going to do the half. So 36-17. Light blue team on top in this final four matchup of rec basketball. Oh, what are your first half thoughts, Colin?
Well, I can tell you two words. Mike Pepper. He's just been playing really well so far. And if he's going to continue it, going into the second half, then it's going to be very tough for the black team to dig themselves out of this hole that they got themselves into.
All right, so we will be right back after this short break between the light blue team and the black team. We'll be right back for the second half.
Sports fans, stay in touch with all of East Longmeadow High School sports by following us on Twitter using our handle at LCAT Sports. And if you miss any of the games on TV, you can watch the game at your leisure by visiting us on YouTube and searching LCAT 01028.
All right, so we're ready for the second half here of this matchup. I'm joined alongside Tyler Maloney, who's on the red team. Tyler, explain what happened so far through the playoffs. What was your last game like?
Well, first round, we had the bye week and came out here against Drew Meyer's team. And we knew we shouldn't take them easy, so we went hard, got the win. They came back a little bit, but we stayed true to our game, and we got the dub, so now we're in here trying to get the win against Pink.
All right, yeah, so now you play the Pink team tonight. What do you guys have to do to be prepared for that game?
Well, first we got to shut down Tyler Miller. That's an obvious. Yeah. He's a great player. He's a varsity player. And then we got to stop Caleb and just I think we have to run the tempo of the game, be quick. That's when we're the best, when we're on fast breaks.
What kind of way are you guys looking to score tonight? You guys more of a shooting team, inside scoring team, or more of a balanced scoring team?
We're pretty balanced. We like to push it, try to get easy layups, but most of us can knock down some threes if we have to.
All right. You've obviously played both of these teams. How'd you match up against each of these teams, if you remember?
We played the black team in the beginning of the year, and we had some nice chemistry going, so we ended up beating them by like 15, 20 points. We had a doubleheader, so it was the second game of the day for us when we played the blue team. Came out a little tired in the first half, and they got a big lead in the first half. But in the second half, we worked our game, we came back, ended up tying it, and then we ended up losing by 4 with the last minute left. So that was a heartbreaker for us.
All right, well, good luck in your game. But quickly, outside of basketball, now football season next year, what are you looking forward to that?
Well, I mean, I'm looking forward to the whole deal. Senior captain, quarterback, like this is going to be my best time of my life probably. It's going to be a lot of fun. Looking forward to getting out there with my buddies, you know, Shea, Humphreys.
Yep.
It's going to be awesome. I think it's going to be a really good experience for us.
And do you think you're going to have a pretty good team next year?
Definitely. Yep. With Mike Magipinto returning, obviously 2,000-yard rusher, he'll do some damage. And then I think we'll be able to hold our own with Richard at receiver. And we got most of our defense returning, so I think we'll be looking good for next year.
All right, well, thank you very much for coming out here, and good luck in your game.
No problem, man.
All right.
Thanks.
So once again, that was Tyler Maloney joining us. He will be playing the next game. He'll be playing the pink team. And now back to this game. It is now 38-17, the light blue team. Really rolling away with this one, Colin.
Yeah, I mean, there hasn't been much scoring, but again, it's 2 minutes into the. Well, there hasn't been much scoring in the second half, but still young, and I think the blue team's just picking up where they left off.
Here's Santon out looking to make a drive, and it's blocked by Nick Demarest. Excellent block, but stolen by Dan Lombardo. That was a good steal by Dan, and a good 2 points there for the black team. Now it's 38-19 with 7:30 to go.
If you're the black team, you just want to keep turning defense into offense like they did just there.
I mean, no one can stop Matt Mooney tonight. There's nothing you can really do about him. Or Mike Pepper, really. Anyone offensively for the blue team, because they've been so.
That was just a shot you have to tip your cap to. Dan Lombardo knocks down the three.
Actually, the ref is going to rule it a two, so apparently he was just on the line.
Oh.
But I thought it was a 3-2, but apparently not. It's 40-21. Here's Mike Pepper once again. A little bit short rebound, Dan Lombardo. Down the floor to Chad, just a little bit too much.
A although they didn't capitalize there, black team starting to get some rhythm offensively now.
Andrew Walls, pump fake for two, little too much rebound. Demarest, he looked like he was fouled there. Mike Pepper for three, just a little too much. Another rebound for the blue team.
That was a double dribble.
It's a good fight for the ball. It's going to stay with blue. So a quick timeout by blue here. With 6:15 to go. So any differences in the second half than the first half, Colin?
Well, the black team is starting to pick it up offensively, but they're going to really have to go now. It's a 19-point deficit. They're running out of time here, and they just have to – every time they score, it seems like Blue's getting it right back. So they just need to start – score. They need to keep up the scoring that they've been doing, but they need to really hold – blue to little to no points here in the second half.
So the blue team is on top 19. Black team's going to need a couple quick baskets to really get back into this game. Here's Walls looking to slow things down. Gives it up to Mooney. Mooney on the drive, stolen by Chap. And he's going to take it all the way to the bucket to lay it in. It's going to be 40-23.
Just what the black team needs to do to get back into this.
The ball gets stuck between the rim and the backboard. It's going to be ruled a jump ball, and back down to the black team it goes. So now 15:55 to go. Black team trailing by 17. Here's Dan Lombardo, gives up to Jake Wilson, who shoots that one up. It's knocked away, taps it up to Matt Mooney, all the way to the bucket to lay it in.
Nice move there, as Matt Mooney's starting to just do what Mike Pepper did in the first half.
Yeah, he just makes it look so easy. And here's Joey Santinello, misses the three, rebound by Walls.
Good
up
job.
To Pepper.
Good job there by Andrew Walls to box out Dan Lombardo, which has been doing really well all night.
Slowing things down now for the black team. Gives it up to Dan Lombardo in the corner. And he almost loses it, but picked up by Chap. Chap drives. That's too much. Knocked away. And Mike Pepper with it, pushing the floor. Gives it up to Matt Mooney. Drives. Oh, my goodness. Off the glass and in.
Just the degree of difficulty on that shot was insanely high, but he seemed to just ignore the defense there.
I mean, how do you defend that? There's really no way you can. Couple flares, couple exchanging of words. I'm not really sure what the call is. I just think Walls pushing Santinello a little bit over there, so things are getting a little dicey. So that group will come out. A new group will come in for both sides. Here's a quick three from Denzel. No good off the rip. Matt Mooney. Oh, too easy. I thought he was going to dunk that, Colin, at the way he's been playing.
Look, he didn't need to there. He just keeps scoring and scoring.
Oh, here he goes again. Well, I mean, why not? It's just too easy.
Late foul called there.
Dan Lombardo looking to turn things around here for the black team. shoots a three. That's way off the mark.
Released that one a little too late.
Thirteen minutes to go. It's 49-23. Blue team on top. Looking to swing it. And nice rebound by Matt Paul. Here's Cowles for three. No good. Rebound by Tanner Patterson.
Although that was an empty possession, just good ball movement all around there by Blue.
Off the glass, no good. Rebound by the Blue team. Here's Cowles, a drive, and he falls pretty hard to the ground.
Appears that is that a flagrant called or a technical?
I'm not sure, but I believe so. But the Blue team has a 26-point lead. 49-23.
I think a flagrant here is Cowles was fouled pretty hard.
So he misses both, but the Blue team will get the ball back.
Black team just getting frustrated here. That was just a complete frustration foul as they just continue to fall further and further out of contention.
And a floater. That's no good. Rebound by Matt Paul. And a nice block by Dan Lombardo to force him to come back to the ground. Black team looking to spark their offense before it's too late.
Chris Chiavelli there taking his first field goal of the game.
So 11 minutes to go. Blue team on top by 26, 49-23 in this final four matchup of rec basketball. And it's going to go back down the other way.
Just an impressive performance thus far from the Blue team. They just haven't shown any let up since the drop, since the jump ball start the game.
Nice drive to the basket for two. They're going to need a lot more of those. Andy Smith looking to drive, and it hits the back of the backboard. It's out of bounds.
Star of the first half, Mike Pepper checks back in.
And another three, that's no good. Here's Devin Denzel for three. He knocks it down. It's 49-28. 21-point game. Starting to chip away a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, they're not taking the highest quality of shots, but they're going to need to take any type of three here to get them back in.
And a nice block by Dan Lombardo. What a presence he is down low.
Yeah, the blue team just having their struggles trying to get inside right now because of how well he's playing interior defense. They just can't get anything by him.
And stolen away. There's some hope left for the black team here. With 9 minutes to go, it's 49-28. Blue team on top. Dylan Bart looking to drive, almost loses it, and it is stolen away. And it's going to go to the blue.
Bardo comes out.
And Chap all the way to the bucket to lay it in. It's 49-30, just a 19-point game now. I know I'm saying just a 19-point game, but from where it has been, it was a 26-point game a couple minutes ago. They cut it back down to 19.
If you're the black team, you just got to keep doing what you've been doing, and hopefully they'll continue to chip away at this lead and be able to get
and a rebound by Jake Wilson. There's Noah Peterson looking to drive, gives it out to Chap. Back in the corner to Noah. And he's fouled. Here's Devin Denzel. Quick jumper, that's good. It's 49-32. Black team chipping away.
Need to continue to get these open looks.
And Andrew Walls falls hard to the floor there.
Can't wait for the next game after this between the red and the pink team.
Yeah, that's going to be quite an exciting matchup because both teams are arguably two of the best teams in the league.
And they both possess two of the best players in the league.
Yeah. I mean, if you think about the red team, you see Tyler Maloney, you see Ryan Taft, Tony DeMarsh, John Bortolussi, and on the pink team, you see Caleb Berard, Tyler Miller, Benny Wright, John Griffin. So both teams are pretty stacked with talent, you could say.
Yeah, I mean, that should be an interesting one to watch is both of those two teams just played stellar throughout the season.
So that is the next game here tonight. Once again, the pink team and the red team. Here's Mike Pepper looking to dribble, gives it on top to Andy Smith. Mike Pepper for a jumper, a little too much, but Walls is going to get that rebound. And he's looking to drive. Oh, excellent look down low. Oh, wow, what a look by Andrew Walls. And that would make it a 20-point game once again. It's 52-32. Chat looking to drive the other way. And Walls takes the charge down on the other side of the floor, so he makes two great consecutive plays. A great look down low for a bounce pass. And a bucket offensively in the last possession. And now he just draws a charge.
Yeah, it was a beautiful pass down low there. I'm not even sure how he got it through. And on the other end, just takes it, draws a charge. And
here's Walls once again looking to score, and I'm not sure what happened here. I don't know if he got kicked out because of a hard foul.
No, I think he's hurt. Yeah, he's holding his knee.
Well, no, that's Andrew Walls who fell to the floor, but Felix Cherengizi, the ref pointed him off the floor. I'm not sure why, because he's the one who actually made the foul, and it appeared to be a pretty hard foul. I don't know if it was too hard of a foul, but I don't know what the rule the ruling is here. But with 5:46 to go, it's a 20-point game, 52-32, light blue team on top. Now, if it is to remain this way, the light blue team will move on to the championship, and that will be played Friday night at the high school.
Yeah, it should be a great one to watch between two great teams. I mean, this team's just been amazing throughout the year. And the other two teams that are playing later to try to earn a spot in that championship game, they will definitely pack a punch for this blue team, should they be able to hold on.
Andy Smith to the line, definitely one of the many X factors, you could say, for the light blue team. I mean, I hope Andrew Wells is okay, because he's over there on the bench. He's holding an ice pack. It appears to be his ankle. So hopefully he is okay.
Yeah, he got up really quickly knowing that something was wrong.
And he also is a key player for the blue team.
Yeah, he's done a really good job of keeping Dan Lombardo in check throughout this game.
54-32. Light blue team on top. Here's Devin Denzel for another three. Man, he's lights out.
Didn't see much of him in the first half, but he's starting to really show it here in late in the second.
So it's a 19-point game with just around 5 minutes to go. Clock is ticking down. Mike Pepper looking to inbound, gives it up top to Andy Smith. Blue team with the commanding lead. Here's Matt Paul. A little too much on that jumper. It's going to stay down with the blue team.
Yeah, I mean, if you're the blue team, you're probably not really in any rush here, just trying to milk some clock.
Yeah, again, there's no shot clock either in in-town basketball.
Yeah, that has its positives and its negatives. I mean, if you're on the other team and you're down by a few points, you can really use that.
And here's Jake Wilson with a rebound, and he throws it a little bit too hard to Joey Santinello. And it goes out of bounds. Kicks it up to Mike Pepper, and they're going to swing the ball around here. Three, no good. Rebound by Matt Paul, though, and they're going to call, I believe it's a 3 second call.
It might have been up and down. I'm not really sure which.
Oh, maybe, yeah. Wasn't clear on the ruling there. Devin for three, just short. Here's Matt Moody off the glass and in.
He's been the reason why this blue team's stayed out in front here.
And now Joey Santinello is kicked out of the game. And he's talking to the ref now, exchanging some words. Probably that can't be repeated here in LCAT. But he threw an elbow. And the ref decided to eject him.
Guess he's departing from the gymnasium.
So with 3 minutes to go, I think it's safe to say that the blue team will move on to the championship here. And it'll be interesting to see who they are going to play. And the championship when the red team matches up against the pink team next. Both very, very good teams.
Yeah, I mean, no matter who wins that game, I think both of those teams can definitely be a challenge for the blue team, as really all three of these teams have just shown that they're the elite teams here in the league.
Dan Lombardo kicks it out. Denzel, three, you bet. He's on fire tonight. 56-38, 2:15 to go. Mike Pepper looking to milk the clock a little bit. Dribbling, gives it down low, Matt Paul, and he's fouled. quite the crowd now that I think will be attending the second game. As we have a large student section off to our right here.
Yeah, it's got the feel of a Division I college game right now.
I mean, the students love coming out here and watching these in-town games because they're always fun to watch. And now just a minute 30 to go. The blue team is on top by 20, 58 to 38.
Looks like with the lead this blue team has, they're just going to let the clock run instead of the typical stop the clock with 2 minutes to go.
Here's Matt Mooney. He's going to take one more three. And that's no good. Rebound. And gives it up to Noah Peterson. Noah Peterson looking to drive. Takes it all the way. Puts it up. No good. Rebound. No good. And here's Mike Pepper. Down the floor. 50 seconds to go. Off the glass. No good. Here's Dan Lombardo. Pulls up from three. No good. 40 seconds to go. And the blue team... it's really starting to slow things down now. Matt Mooney on top to Cowles. Oh, he line drive three. That's an air ball. He's smiling about that one. And the blue team will move on to the championship here. And it's only in a couple hours they'll know who they will be playing after this next matchup between the red and the pink team. Here's Jake Wilson for three. And that ball had no spin on it whatsoever. That was literally a knuckleball shot. It's funny look at, and another three back down the other end. And confusion on the floor, but it doesn't matter. The game is over, 58-38. Colin, your final thoughts of that game?
Well, really hard fought win there by the blue team. The black team was in it early, and they just could not keep up with the amazing tempo that this blue team had. But if you're the blue team, I wouldn't be worried about who you're facing in the championship. I'd be worried about the condition of one of your best players, Andrew Walls, after taking the hit to the leg.
Yeah. So definitely we hope that Walls does get better for the championship game, but a great matchup between the two teams. And we're also looking forward to the championship next matchup. Up next is the pink team and the red team. We hope you join us for that. Thank you.